We swap on the guitars again. We should play the Jeopardy music, you know.
We're actually going to play a rendition of that with our new band, Leviathan. This is for my dad. I'm playing organ on it. It's going to be sick. Smoke on the Water style.
Can your father sing?
He can sing. He can. In tune, who knows? He was in the church choir for a long time, which means you can
get his belt the concepts.
He can belt it out.
Yeah.
Oh, Trev.
You've got to talk him into joining you one night and singing a song or two together.
Listen, we've been trying to get him to play guitar for years. All he does is he builds them. Like, he'll go buy some parts and like just build a guitar. And our dad is like, how old is he, 56, 55?
Oh, he's an old guy.
He's about to be 55 coming up. And just a rock, as rock solid of a music fan as you could ever get in the world. But he never learned how to play anything.
And you both are musicians. That's pretty amazing, actually, really.
And neither did our mother. Like, we didn't have a musical household. We just listened to Simon and Garfunkel on repeat and a little bit of Lynyrd Skynyrd. And, you know, that's pretty much
it. Are those your two biggest influences?
I mean, those were the two first ones. Yeah. The Beatles, Simon and Garfunkel, I mean, Bruce Springsteen. You know, the early ones.
Yeah, I mean, it just, there's just, I mean, it's like, it's kind of like a question of, like, what's your favorite band? Because, I mean, if you're constantly working on your musicianship, you're pretty much trying in some form or fashion to listen to everything. Like, if something happens to be, you know, happens to come across your mind, or you happen to hear it somewhere, you try to like always get something out of it, see if there's anything in it that's worth taking out of it.
And then you go back and listen to Brian McKnight's Back at One, and then you're like, one, you're like a dream come true. And then you're crying, and then you're on the middle school dance floor again, and then all that crazy Django Reinhardt you were listening to was like, that was cool, but it wasn't Back at One.
That's a great music.
It is a great music. But speaking of, okay, so this ties into
the next song. You guys seem like each other's best friend. You know,
we are.
I mean, you really do.
For better or worse.
It comes out with everything you're talking about, everything your music. It's pretty cool, actually. But so, okay, what are you going to play?
Okay, so tying it all in, we're talking about like formative bands. There's some music you only hear at the gas station, or some music you only hear at the grocery store, and like, it used to be on the top of the pop charts, but then somehow fell off and fell into this oblivion of like Muzak, like the stuff you can't get rid of, like that one Dave Matthews Band song that no Dave Matthews Band fan likes, but it's playing all the time at the Kroger.
So it's a grocery store pop.
Yeah,
I mean, you guys know what I'm talking about, though, right? You've heard these songs and you're like, man, this was popular back in the day. Like, what happened? It didn't turn into classic radio or whatever. And anyway. Every time I used to go to the dentist, I would hear like the same Steve Winwood song, or the same Celine Dion. I love her, she's got a voice of an angel. But there's something about that one song, That's the Way It Is, that really makes me want to curl up in a ball and really like hurl myself off the nearest cliff. Anyway, so I was, you know, under anesthesia at the dentist, listening to Celine Dion. And I was like, this music is probably everywhere. So Seth came up with this piece of music and we put a song together called Soft Rock. And we're about to play that for you right quick.
Soft Rock.
Doesn't know what she's aiming for. She
sometimes makes him feel more alive. Just the innocence it's ending, the first cut that plumbs the depths. And it's the way that they all look at you and wants you to fill in the rest. When it's Don Henley and Phil Collins, Michael Bolton and Sheryl Crow, stop right from this direction, the softening glow. Maybe I don't know, man, what more is there to know? Stop right from this direction, the softening glow. She can just scissor out of her hair. And the cliches are never ending. If you fly, then you gotta fall. And nothing gold can stay if there wasn't any gold at all. When it's Don Henley and Phil Collins, Michael Bolton and Sheryl Crow, it's all right for this direction.
Listening to Smashing Pumpkins and I love Pearl Jam still. Okay, I'm still a kid, really. No Limp Bizkit, no. Limp Bizkit was just, you know, that was the early years. But, you know, I tried not to sound too country, or I did, but then I was just like, you know what, this is just the way I sound, and I'm just gonna sing it.
I would not think that song could be described as a country song. I heard a lot of Irish in that.
Believe it or not. I mean, we're Scots Irish.
I've heard a ton of that. Seriously.
They don't use the Irish.
I'm sorry? sorry?
You seek out the Irish.
I seek out the Irish. I do. I really do.
I've heard you say the word Irish a lot of times tonight.
I love the Irish people.
The Irish are great people. Ireland is beautiful.
Well, then I was kind of close. Listen to a guy named Damien Rice. Sometimes you got a little sound like him. Really, really wonderful.
I'll have to find it for our voice.
Loved it.
I'll find it.
I will.
The brothers Key, Seth, and Tyler Key.